What's good, everybody? Welcome back to another My Damn Toys video. Today, ladies and gentlemen, we have a brand new WWE Ultimate Edition review on the brand new Ultimate Edition Kane and Undertaker figures. If you guys missed our video from yesterday, we literally just broke these down yesterday. Like, we got the images, you know, we just had those, like, one prototype style images. And then on yesterday, I revealed some more images to you guys and we talked about it a little bit. And here they are in the flesh. I said they'd be arriving soon and here they are, man. Very excited for these. If you are already excited for them and you want to grab them, man, go over to RingsideCollectiblesWrestlingFigures.com. I do believe they are in stock right now. You can pick up the Kane and the Undertaker. Use promo code MDTOYS to save 10%, man. You guys are absolutely killing it with the code. You guys are absolute beasts. Please keep that up. It means the world to me. And every time you use the code, it shows the support to the channel, and I really, really appreciate it, man. I cannot stress that enough. You guys are absolute beasts. While on top of that, man, please leave me a like as we dive into the review, man. We got Kane and Undertaker here. Very excited for both of these. I wasn't too excited about Undertaker until yesterday when we took a look at those images. So let's go ahead and break it down, man. As you guys can see, front viewing windows, Ultimate Edition logos here. You got their names across the top. On the side, you do get a beautiful image of both men here. I love the images that they chose here. I like the Undertaker's a little bit more. However, still digging both. On the back, you do get a product image of the figure at the top over there. You get their names across the side, and then you get a cool image of Kane and Undertaker here, and then Kane over there by himself looking like an absolute boss. But as we spin it around, guys, you got their names on the side, Ultimate Edition logos there, and that pretty much breaks down our packaging, man. I cannot wait to crack these open any longer. So with that being said, man, let's crack Undertaker and Kane out of their Ultimate Edition packaging. So here's Kane and Undertaker out of the packaging, man. Really enjoying what I'm seeing right now, man. Really, really enjoying it. I am pretty blown away, actually, by what we're getting. And I'm going to get into all of those different things as we progress through the review, guys. But I think you're in for a treat. I think anybody who's a fan of either of these guys, these are going to be must grabs. But we won't know until we dive into all the details of both of these figures. So what we're going to do first is take a closer look at Undertaker's accessories and Undertaker, and then we will run it back and take a closer look at Kane's accessories and Kane. Now, since this is Ultimate Edition, and we did two in one video, it is going to be a longer review, so definitely check it out. Stay tuned to the end, man. Let's see how good these figures are and dive into Undertaker's accessories. All right, man, so diving into Undertaker's accessories, again, it is Ultimate Edition, man, so you know you get a slew of stuff. Let's start off with our head sculpts. Now, this is one of the main talking points of this Undertaker figure, right? Because when we first saw it, it looked like Michael Jackson. Everybody was spamming the memes and just going crazy about it and saying, this figure looks like Michael Jackson and gave him a real hard time. Well, Brad, it looks like they did fix that. The eye makeup's not as crazy. The beard looks a lot better. It just looks a lot more realistic. I really like the hair that's got going on. Now, is it a perfect head sculpt? I don't think so, but I think it does capture the likeness of Undertaker, and I think you're going to be pretty happy with it. I like how they have that dark, wet, emo-looking hair down in the face there, drooping down the sides. Not like Bret Hart, where it interrupts it, but it looks really good. I like that one. Next up, guys, we do have the tongue-out head sculpt with the eyes rolling back. Now, we saw this on Basic 100 Undertaker. Tongue-out looks really great. I love this head sculpt. I just don't like it for this figure. I think we could have done something a little bit better, because I don't think it's completely accurate with the timeline. His facial hair is even different, you know what I'm saying? Like, it's completely a different time frame there for the Undertaker, but it's still a really good head sculpt. The likeness is there, it looks sick, and it's gonna go great on other figures, but I don't know, at least you have it for other Undertakers, and the likeness is totally there. And the last head sculpt that we have is probably my least favorite. It just looks a bit long to me, and I think this did come on the Ringside exclusive Undertaker as Kane figure that we got not too long ago. Long sideburns, again, the facial hair is a little bit different, and it just looks weird. I don't like this head sculpt for whatever reason. It just looks a bit goofy to me. However, you know, it's still a head sculpt there, and you know, you can use it. It doesn't have the eye black on there, so if you dig that head sculpt, that totally works. But outside of that, guys, you do get interchangeable hands. Out of the packaging, he comes with mic holding slash regular, you know, weapon holding hands with the fingerless gloves. They look really good, and it wouldn't be an Undertaker figure without choke slamming hands, so you got the same glove mold. We've seen this, you know, we've seen these 100 times before. And the last two hands we have, guys, is the throat cutting or throat slitting hands or whatever you want to call it, you know, where he like puts his hand out wide and then comes across the throat like so. Really sick. This is the first time I think we've seen this before with the, you know, the glove sculpt over the thumbs up. And then we have the wide open hand here with the glove on there as well. So this could be a pre-choke slamming hand and a little Tombstone Powerdriver, you know, throat slit hand there. So that's pretty cool. I like it a lot. I like that we got these hands in there. And the only thing I'd really like to see is this glove mold on a hand that's like this, you know, like the entrance hand or like on the knee there. So that's the last one I'd like to see. But outside of that, guys, we do have his entrance coat, which is very synonymous with Ultimate Edition figures. You guys will notice that it does clasp in the front right here, and to put it on the figure, you're actually going to, or you don't have to, but it would probably help if you remove the arms from the Undertaker figure. So what you can do is just kind of pop this out right here and then come over here and do the same thing. Then you can slide this torso up inside the jacket, clasp it in the front, like so, and then come back and import your arms. Now, I will say it is a little bit tricky the first time you do it, but if you line up the butterfly joints, which we'll get into in the articulation standpoint, you know, you line up those butterfly joints and kind of press it in there, it will go on there, and there you go. So, if you guys were wondering what the jacket looked like or the entrance vest looks like on the figure, here you go. Nice little standard right there. It's not completely clasped in the front, but this is really sweet. So, if you zoom in here, guys, you will see all the sculpted details. You have all these buckles and little things going on. Nice details, man, like the buttons and all the different details that you got going on. You got these little nice flowy sculpt going to it. Even on the back right here, you guys will notice again, just look at all the sculpted detail on here. Again, like you do get a little bit of cloth here on the back. Like this cape is cloth. The cape on the back is cloth, but it's just like a weird material. Like it's not stretchy. It's like literally like kind of, I don't even know how to describe that. Like it's a tougher material and it's very nice. It's very high quality and stuff, but this is a rubber part of the jacket. And you guys can see it doesn't clasp all the way. It is a little bit difficult to clasp, but if you maneuver it enough, you should be able to get it in there. But overall, it's a nice piece, but that pretty much wraps up Undertaker's accessories on the Ultimate Edition Taker. All right, guys, so getting into the Undertaker figure itself, we've already covered the head sculpt a little bit, but you guys can kind of see how it sits on the neck. It sits pretty nice. I like it a lot. I think it looks fantastic. Again, not a perfect head, but I like it. I like it a lot. If we move the hair back just a little bit, guys, you guys can get into this torso. Now, I know a lot of people had issues, even me. I had issues with this torso before and how it kind of was shaped, but after looking at it from far away, I'm not really, it doesn't look that bad actually in person as it did in the promo images. And another thing I want to add is that this is actually a little rubber piece that you can pull back and there is black underneath there. And it since it is like soft goods right here, or like it's like a softer pliable material, you can actually operate the butterfly joints as usual. Now it's not like perfect, but you do get a little bit into that. Like you can definitely get that articulation in there. Again, it's not perfect and it does come back a little, but it's better than not having it at all. And it's pretty sweet. I like the way they did that. Great sculpted stuff right here on the stomach, on the shoulders, the buckles and stuff. Double jointed arms. I like the size of them. I like the size of the shoulders. Crotch piece even has some stuff, you know, sculpted onto the side, which is really cool. On the back, you do get the same continued buckles and patterns and stuff going on. On the side of the leg, you still get some nice patterns. The same pattern as on the crotch mold there with the X's and the, you know, like the little chain link there. One thing I did have is like my left lower leg is loose right there, which is very annoying. So you guys can see that right there, but I think it's because it's the pinless joints, which is, I don't like it at all. But this guy's on ball joints, which we'll get into in just a moment. But the boot mold, the new boots, I do like, but they're kind of really plain. Like, I kind of wish that we had something going on with them, even if they were, like, kind of glossy or something. I don't know. Like, they're very plain Jane. They're literally just flat, strapless boots with the toe articulation, which is nice, but I think I would have liked to have seen something else. But I'm really digging the way this figure looks. Let's get into some articulation right quick. Now, as far as articulation, he can look down and say, you know, it's just a ball joint. It's no ball hinge or anything. Ab crunch is kind of non-existent. You know how the Ultimate Editions do. You do get the little diaphragm hammer. Again, you do get, you know, some decent little articulation here out of this butterfly joint. And then you do have the double jointed arms, which are nice. One thing that I will say about Ultimate Edition WWE figures is they really need to fix the shoulders and the arms. I feel like they get really, really loose up here with the butterfly joints, which is probably something that will improve over time, but they definitely get loose. And see, standing up here, it doesn't really look that bad as far as the torso is concerned about being like oversized. Like it really doesn't look that bad. He can do the splitsies because he's on ball joints, but again, man, that lower leg right there is, he can't do the double jointed knee. You get the boot rotation there, which is kind of loose too. Like the boot rotation is a little loose. You do get the toe pivot right there, which is really nice. I mean, I like the figure overall, but it definitely has its, you know, it definitely has its issues, which I do like that the Undertaker is on ball joints right here. A lot of his long pants ones are on ball joints, but I think this is the first tights Undertaker that is on ball joints. And for your Undertaker figure comparisons, I could have swore I had the Network Spotlight figure, but I can't find it for whatever reason. So I do have the Defining Moment slash, I think that's the Defining Moments on the right, and then that is the Elite 23 on the left, if I'm not mistaken. I do apologize. I could have swore that I had the Network Spotlight. I don't know where it is, so that's kind of bummerific, but as far as Undertakers that are kind of between eras here, I like the way all of these look. I think they look great up next to each other. And again, like I feel like almost this torso works a little better because it gives him a little bit more girth. I feel like Undertaker and Kane have been a lot skinnier than they should be from Mattel. So I actually dig this a lot more than what we've gotten in the past. Like I think the proportions are really great for Taker here with the new Ultimate Edition. All right, guys, so diving into Kane's accessories, starting out with the head sculpt. This is the base head sculpt that comes out of the packaging. And I like this a lot. I think this is the best Kane head sculpt that they've made. Now, I will will say that's not saying very much, because the other Kanes they've made, I guess necessarily haven't been bad, but they reused it and reused it and reused it and reused it over and over and over again. So to see a new sculpt and it to have better likeness and just look a lot better, I really enjoy it. Of course, you do have some black missing on the mask sculpt, but I really like the way the paint looks over the eyes. I think the likeness looks a lot better. Not very big on the hair mold, but I still think it's okay. You know, it's not terrible, but it's not my favorite. However, I do enjoy the head sculpt, and then you do have the hair pull back head sculpt, which I don't know. It's not a terrible head sculpt, but the hair is behind the ears there. I definitely prefer the hair in front of the ears, but this isn't a bad head sculpt by any means. Also got to continue the stripes there to complete the mask, so that's kind of unfortunate, but nothing a little paint up can't fix. But I like both head sculpts overall. I definitely prefer this one over this one, but at the same time, they both look nice. Now, outside of that, guys, you do get interchangeable hands. You get regular mic holding hands out of the packaging. You don't get choke slamming hands, but you do get the, like, okay, you could call these pre-choke slam hands, and you could also call these like the entrance hands where he raises up his hands and then, you know, the turnbuckle posts explode. But this is like the R-Truth glove mold, which is really cool in the right hand, and black, which I really enjoy for the Kane, because, you know, it gives it that material look. And then you have the plain, you know, skin tone hand, which his hands are probably a little bit too small for the figure, but that's not a huge deal. And then we also get the WWF Championship, which looks beautiful, which is the belt that was on television when I was growing up. And then shortly after that, the Ruthless Aggression era started. But what a beautiful championship. It'll never get old. We've seen this multiple times. It's beautiful in figure form and beautiful in real life. One of my favorite title designs of all time. We also have the voice changer, which we have seen multiple times. No, we've literally seen this 100 times. We've seen it with the Elite 12, the Hall of Champions, this figure, and that's probably it. But they molded it in things just got weird. But we've seen the voice changer before. And then we have the infamous Kane cape that he wore like one time at a live event or something like that. So they decided to throw it in figure form. You have like the Sheen look at the top, which is really nice. It is a stretchy material. Be careful when stretching it, but it does clasp in the front like so. And then you have the Kane pattern going down the backside, and it does clasp in front like that. Very nice quality material right there if you guys want to see it on the figure. And then you can just drape it over the shoulders like so, and it hangs down pretty nicely. I love the way it looks on the figure. I think it captures the figure perfectly too. Like, I like the way it fits the figure and everything. Very nice quality, like I said. But that pretty much wraps up Kane's accessories, man, outside of his gauntlets on his hands there. Besides his gauntlets on there, yeah, pretty sweet stuff. So getting into Kane himself, guys, starting out with the head sculpt, we've already took a look at it. I like it a lot, especially on the figure. I dig this a lot. I'll go ahead and tell you right now, probably the best Kane figure they've ever made. Like, I'll just be straight up with you. I think it is the best Kane they've ever made. Pretty bold statement. You know, you got some great figures out there, which we're gonna get into, but I think straight up best Kane they've ever made. Now, getting into the rest of the figure, man, I really like the way they did the torso right here. Again, you're not gonna get the greatest articulation out of these guys. Sorry, I bumped the camera like a dumb jackass. Like, you're not gonna get the best out of it. However, I like the girth to it. I like the sculpt to it. I think it looks really, really nice. Just like the Undertaker and other Ultimate Editions, you do get the butterfly joint right here, which is crazy. You get the skin tone on this side, and then you actually do get coverage here, which doesn't look stupid with a tattoo like the Rock figure. It actually looks really nice because you get that continuation of black stripes with the red, and it continues on the back too. So that's really, really clean. Now, one thing you're probably noticing immediately is in the pits of this double jointed arm here on the right arm, you're going to get skin tone leaking through right here. So it looks like they added factory paint red over skin tone double jointed arms, and I don't know why they would do that. Maybe it'll be a running change where they fix it, but that's pretty annoying. I will say that is pretty annoying. You guys can see where the paint ends right there. So, like, I don't know why they decided to do that. I don't know if it was out of their control or what, but that's kind of, you know, especially for an Ultimate Edition, man, pretty disappointing. I don't know if I mentioned it, but you do get the sculpted detail right here with the, you know, the studs on the side of the attire. You also get the belt right here along with the cuffs. Now, one thing a lot of people are saying is that this is actually sculpted on, and I don't think that's the case. I think this is a loose piece. I think it's like Hangman Adam Page, where, you know, it's like the cowboy belt. It's like the, you know, the belt over the crotch piece, and it's loose. So I would be careful. Like, when you get the figure, man, don't move it a lot, because once this becomes loose, it may jostle all over the place. And I actually glued my, you know, my Adam Page one in place. That way it wouldn't move. However, you know, you don't want to get that out of whack. But you say, like, it's rotated. You could rotate it to get it more in line. But I really like that they included this instead of painting it on. It looks really nice put on there. Even if it's not sculpted, just having that around the waist looks so much better to me. Going down to the pants, same pants as we've seen before with the stripes and stuff. He is also, you know, painted on stitching right here. No sculpted detail, but it is not pinless, and he does have the same boots as Undertaker, which is accurate for the time. But again, I feel like the gloss would have looked better and more accurate, but, you know, it's the same deal there. And he is not on ball joints, if you guys were wondering. But damn, bro, this Kane is sick. Like, don't get me wrong, it's got its issues, but it is a very fun figure. It's very awesome. I like it a lot. I think everybody that enjoys Kane will love this figure. Poses around really well. If you can look past some minor gripes, I think you are going to get a ton of enjoyment
enjoyment out of it.
And for your Kane figure comparisons, guys, we do have the Elite 12 over here. We have the Ultimate Edition right here. We have the Undertaker as Kane ringside exclusive that I just switched out into Kane pretty much. That way, you know, I'd have the double-sleeved Elite look. And then we have the inverted WrestleMania gear right here in the black and red. And I like all of them, but again, man, these head sculpts don't compare to this one. And here is the Ultimate Edition up next to the Elite here. And the Elite 12 is still amazing, but I think the Ultimate Edition is now the new Elite 12, if that makes sense, man. Looks sick AF. I love the way that it came out. I think this Kane is just badass. It encaptures everything about nostalgia and looking at Kane and, you know, his debut and how amazing he is. So I think it's sweet. I enjoy it a lot. And yeah, man, I think they absolutely nailed it. Outside of a few little predicaments. And then for your other Kane figure comparison, guys, here he is up next to his tag team partner on Vindication, Braun Strowman, there in the monster mask. These guys are running rampant, and I don't know who the hell's going to stop them, but there's Kane and Braun together if you wanted to see those ups next to each other before they got on PickFed Television, because I think I'm going to use this in PickFed Television. But that pretty much wraps it up for us, guys. 2-in-1 Ultimate Edition review on Kane and Undertaker. Love both of these figures a ton, man. Really do. I think Kane is superior. If I had to pick one, I would totally pick Kane. I just think overall it's better. It's a total upgrade from his Elite 12 counterpart, which is, you know, a lot of people dub as one of the best Kane figures or WWE Elite figures of all time. So I think this figure's fantastic outside of the freaking skin tone and the elbow, which I don't like. I just had a ton of fun posing it around. The Undertaker's fun to pose around as well, but I would say the Kane is a better overall figure though. Just no doubt about it. I like the Kane more, but if you guys would like to grab either of these, definitely go over to Ringside Collectibles, WrestlingFigures.com. Use promo code MDTOYS to save yourselves 10% when shopping over there. Grab these figures, man. You know how the Ultimate Editions go, right? I mean, these figures will be $30 or $35, and then tomorrow they'll be $350. So you definitely want to get your order in there. Use code MDTOYS to save yourself a little bit of money. Add it to another order. That way, you know, you can get some more goodies along the way. Save more on your discount code. But that is going to wrap it up here, man. Overall, highly recommend both. I think the Undertaker is great. I think the Kane is great. But if I had to pick one, I would pick the Kane. I would say choose Kane over Undertaker. But everybody has their preferences and stuff, man. But I'm getting out of here. Thank you guys so very much for watching. I hope you guys did enjoy. Let me know who you would choose down below. What do you think of these figures? I'm getting out of here, man. Thank you for watching. Subscribe to the channel, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Thank you. Don't cross the line like those stupid, idiot, dumb skin tone arms underneath the red of the double-jointed arm Kane. You crossed the line. I've been